Sorry, it's them actually making two different videos. So the last one I talked about the CMR and the CCR bill. Well, I want to talk about what should you expect in a bill. Like, if you are buying a bill, what should be the contents of a bill? Yes, you know, we have first grade, we have second grade, we have third grade, we have last grade, but what should I expect? Okay, if eventually I buy a first grade bill and I don't miss what I like, how should I sell? Do you get? Now, a bill is simply a bundle of clothes wrapped together, bundle of used clothes wrapped together in a polythene like China bill, in a cotton sack like London bill, or in a kind of woolen material like some other kind of bills. Yes. Now, when you open a bill, a bill might have like 300, 400 pieces of clothes. And let's say you open a first grade bill. And after opening a first grade bill, you discover that the first grade is not really first grade. What do you do? Do you just run at loss? No. Now, when you open a bill, you are supposed to grade it. Yes, we know the company have grade. We know the company has graded it already. But you need to regrade. Now, by regrading, because of the fact that these companies pack different bill at a time, sometimes they get to pack the bad ones. And really, a first grade bill does not mean that everything will be 101% good. It only means that at least 70-80% of it is going to be good. While the remaining 20%, which is going to be like accidental one, and we should not need more much of repairs, would be there. Now, when you buy that kind of bill, what do you do? In a bill, you can't choose the fact that this is the size I want. You can carry a top bill and everything will be big size. That is not the company's fault. That is not your fault. That is not your supplier's fault. You can carry a bill and everything will be small size. That is not your fault. That is not your supplier's fault. And that is not the company's fault. You can also carry a bill and everything will be sleeveless. That is not your fault either, and that is not your supplier fault. But when you carry a bill and when you open the bill is like, they tell you this bill is first grade, and you can hardly count 20% of it being clean, then that is either your supplier fault or the company's fault. Now, how do you handle this fault in such a way that you would not make a loss? Okay, now this top I am wearing, this particular top I'm wearing, is Okrika. Yes. Let me say, you can see the color of the top very well now. Okay, in a bale of chiffon top, there are 400 pieces. Now, if you have a bale, I sell a bale 150k anyway. Now, 400 divided by 150 is 4400. That means you can sell a top at 400 naira each, and you'll be getting your cost price, which is 160,000 naira. Now, let's assume 200 of that tops are very, very good. Now, when you sell the 200 of that tops like 7,700, I'm just making this, you know, we all go to the market, we all buy things from the market. So I'm trying to go with the market that is not too expensive. I have people that sell top as high as 1.5. I can't buy this top outside now and not spend up to 1.5, because the top is a very, very quality top. So now, if you sell 200 of this kind of top for 700 naira, that's 140,000. Now let me assume that the under 200 pieces are not good, and you sell that under 200 pieces that are not good for 400 naira, that is 80,000, which means at the end of the day you have a profit of 70,000. Note that the percentage of what was not good is actually 50%. That's 200 was good, 50%, and 200 was bad, 50%. So you make 80,000 at the minimum level. Now, in a real first grade top, you should be able to get at least 250 that should be good, and maybe 100 that. It's not that they are bad though, but they're not that good. Maybe they're sleeveless, or they have a stain, or maybe their button is removed or something. Now for children wear is basically very expensive. So we buy children wear of 270,000 for bill. That's the highest, 270 for a bill, and in that bill you get like 600 pieces. That means you are buying, you are selling each top, let's assume it has 600 pieces. That means divided by 270, that means you are selling each top at the minimal rate of 425, because for 400 times 600 is 240,000. Yes. So now, because of this price, these are what you are going to do. You pick this trouser one side, you pick the polo top, you pick the gowns, you pick the whatever, and then you grade them. And by grading, you pick, okay, this is the first, this is the second, and this is the third. And let's assume the first are those that cost 1,000, you can sell them for like 1,000. I'm going to assume that out of the 600 pieces you buy, 200 are first grade. So when you sell them for 1,000, that's 200,000. Now 200 are second grade. So when you sell the other 200 are second grade for, let's say 500, that's 100,000. Now 200 at third grade, which I'm going to say, like, let me say 200. Now that is another 40,000. No, 40 plus 100 is 140. 140 plus 200 is 340, and you buy for 270. Now I just gave this price like the kind of the least price I feel you can sell children. In my area, they sell children children jean as high as 15. Children jean, and they sell all these pin down here. They don't, they sell another 200-300 naira per one. So now that's for children wear. And let's go to menjin. Menjin is basically very expensive. Menjin is 170 for London. I don't know about China. And we get like, if you're buying jean, like plainly menjin, you're getting like 150 pieces for 200,000. That's like 1,000 naira above. Now you can't sell menjin less than 3,000. If I have someone that buys shirts, men shirts from me, I sell for 3,000. Yeah, that high. So all of these goods, you have to, when you buy a bill, you have to be the one to grade it. Now what I advise you do is you count, okay, this bill has so pieces, divided by the amount you used to buy it. Whatever amount you are getting, which is like 400 for the top, should be the minimum price you can sell. That, like, you know, okay, all this clearance sale, the only amount I can sell my clearance sale is for 400. You are not selling your clearance sale less than for 400 then, for tops anyway, or for children wears. But the other ones that are not clearance, you sell them like double or triple your cost price per one, so that at the end of the day, because you can't sell Okrika in one sitting, it's a lot. So you have to give yourself a lot of time to sell, and now because you are going to spend a lot of time, so that you won't spend the money, so that people don't buy on credit and not give you money. I usually advise that even if you want to sell on credit, you collect, okay, 400, that's the amount one top comes with. You want to buy 5, right? And you want to take it, no, give me my cost price. I'm not telling you it's my cost, I'll just say give me a deposit of so amount. If your deposit is not so amount, I cannot sell. So that way you make profit from what you are selling. Not that you sell and you don't have money to go back to market, or you now say I sell, I buy, and I run at loss. It doesn't work that way. Now if you are the type that buy bags, shoes, all these things are great, and you need to be current with the market price to know how to sell too. So just like the clothes bill, you have to divide what you are buying. You have to divide what you are buying versus the quantity you are buying over the price you used to buy. Now when you divide it, whatever you get is your least price that you should sell. Okay, that's so far the only way I can explain. I hope you actually understand my point. Well, if you have any question, you can always reach out to me. I'm very, very much available on WhatsApp. Thank you.